Okay. I think we're live. Those who catch the replay, you know we go through this every time. Takes me a minute. All right, come on in, guys. Our Sunday night routine. Hi, Laura. Hi, Jeff. Hi, Amanda. Hi, Emma. Nice to see you guys. Hey. Hey, Jessica, Karen, Jason, and Kylie. Everybody come on in. Okay, so here's the drill. What we normally do, if you're new to this, I talk a little bit. I talk a lot. I could talk to a wall. But I'm talking with value. I'm going to give you something that can help you. And then we'll get into a little bit of a group healing, like just a couple of minutes. And then I'll open up the floor for readings. And I'll take, I think, maybe one tonight. We'll see what happens. And I have a way for you guys to get intuitive readings and guidance outside of these lives if you feel like you are in need. So we will get right to it. Hi, Shelly, Allison, Brooke. Hello, hello. Awesome. Good to see you all. And yay, go Chiefs. I'm being supportive of Jeff, so I hope they win. But what I really want to talk about tonight is how our emotions are our teachers. They're our guidance. There are signposts along the way. There are angels in disguise, like our emotions. They're always telling us something. And emotions, if you think of the word, the root word, it's energy in motion. So emotions, where we get stuck is we feel like and adopt the belief system that we are what we're feeling. So when we feel depressed, we say, oh, this energy in motion that is moving through me, like this, that is me. Like I am depression, or I am anxiety, or I am angry, or I am hopeless, or I am a failure, or I am whatever, that we feel that moving through us. And we're like, that is me, but it's just an energy. And then on the flip side of that, in the spiritual world, what I see happening, or in the energy healing space, is the teaching of just clear it, just clear it, just clear it, just clear it. And I noticed, I have some news to share with you all tonight, but as this was trying to unfold in my life for my business, has to do with where I practice, my emotions were showing me all along like what really wanted to happen and what really wanted to come through. Hi, Steph. Hi, Leah. I was going to say hi to you guys as you come in. But my emotions, there's a little bit of falsehood teaching around them. Like clear it, get it out if it's not positive. And then also on the, like the way the traditional medical side is, if you're feeling something, well, you must have a chemical imbalance in your brain and we must medicate you for a theory. Antidepressants, anti-anxiety drugs, love them. I will prescribe them anytime someone's like, Jen, I need it. It's my lifeline. I just have to get through right now. Great. But honestly, you don't have a chemical imbalance. You have energy moving through your body, energy in motion, and those drugs have actually never been proven because chemical imbalance is a theory. That's never been proven either. So we're not really sure why the drugs work, but they do. And so that's great when we need them. But just keep in mind your emotions, your guideposts, your angels, your signs, they're always, always teaching you something. And before we clear it, let's learn something from it. So story time, what my emotions have been showing me was really like what my heart has wanted for my business for a long time. And I feel like sometimes our ego tries to talk us out of what is best for us to keep us safe. And so I went the long way. I have some new ventures going on with my business, and my emotions were all along telling me where I wanted to be, what I wanted to create, how I wanted to do my business. But I didn't think that I could do that. Like I would be, the days that I worked from home, it felt really, really good. The days I was in creation, it felt really, really good. There's an email coming out tomorrow. I'll tell you where my new location will be and all the details. So if you're not subscribed to my email list, you can go to inspirehealthbyjen.com and just click on like the little banner or the pop-up. You can like download something for free. Just put your email on there. I won't spam you. I don't send a whole lot of emails, but I will let you know about important things. And my emotions, like I just kept feeling so lit up about some of the things that I was doing. But my mind, to keep me safe, was like, no, Jen, you have to go to this place. You have to practice here. You have to be here and do it this way to be safe, right? And that, like, it really wasn't getting me anywhere. So I will tell you, all in the email, the details about where I'm going, what I'm doing to practice. But as far as Sunday nights, I'm not going anywhere. And we actually have some really exciting things coming up. I've been able to give more attention to the podcast that's coming out January 3rd. So if you're subscribed to my email or you follow me on Instagram, you'll get pretty information on the podcast. And it's not like our Sunday nights. What's really cool is like this is kind of the energy and the... I'm a Gemini sun and moon, so I have like... And manifesting generator. So I have lots of moving parts about me, my interests, my personality, what I'm here to do to serve. And the podcast is like really the medical side with the spiritual side thrown in. Like we're going through a lot of research in a way that's digestible, easy to understand about your body, what's making your body well, what's making your body sick. Spirit Circle is a membership that will be coming up later in 2023 that this community is just ready for. We're ready to go deeper. And then my I Am Woman program for women who want to take their hormone healing to the next level, because oh my gosh, we'll get on that. That's a podcast episode coming. But as women, we're like living in men in states of hormone imbalance that it's like just how we think that we're supposed to live and deal with symptoms, and it's actually not. And there's actually a really holistic, easy way out of it that I've learned for myself this year. So yeah. Oh, Katie, I want you to be on the podcast and talk about Haven and how you, in your journey, how you got here. So yeah, if you have any questions, topics you know you want covered on the podcast, then send me a message. It's pretty much just like what Jen's thinking and feeling, but we'd love to have your questions for the podcast. Or if you have a story, like an energy story, an angel story, a healing story, all of it, Katie, you're going to be on there because your story is amazing. So if you want, I'll invite you. We'll chat soon. Okay, so back to emotions being our teacher. So here I am thinking that, one, I thought I was going to buy a wellness center and I didn't, because my emotions were like, you are trying to adopt a baby that's screaming and this isn't right for you. So got through that part. And then my emotions were like, oh, you're going to go to this other place and do this other thing. And yet I was ignoring what was really lighting me up and where my heart really, really wanted to be. And I'll tell you guys all in the email. I'm letting the words flow through me. So subscribe to my email list if you're not already there, and I'll tell you where I'll be and what is coming up. Yeah, car A. Emma called this on my birthday reading back in June. She gave me a reading here on Instagram. It was not planned. It just happened. Like through the reading, was like, Jen needs a reading. Yep. And Jason said, so car A is no longer. It was red and it put it out, and we all, well, a lot of us knew it was coming. So, but now I knew that, kind of got through that, had this next dream and vision lined up, and I wasn't listening to what my emotions were saying. And when this message came through about where I really need to be and what I really need to do for my business, like I was honestly crushed at first. And that's the thing with emotions, is sometimes what they're telling us is not easy and it's not fun and it's not where we want to be. But to get to the other side of it, and even just like little things that come up, like it's how many days after Thanksgiving we're all tired and like exhausted and been around a lot of energy and people, and like we haven't had time for ourselves. So emotions can teach us where we need boundaries. Emotions can be showing us like what's lighting us up, what's dragging us down. And especially women, when it comes to PMS, if you're noticing, if your hormones and like your Dutch test and your labs and everything looks really good, like physiologically, and you're still having these swings energetically around your cycle, like late luteal, early menstrual, like that's a time to retreat. You were energetically designed to not be out and about and with all these people and doing all the things at that time. And as women, we're like, oh, I have really bad PMS, but like you're not honoring your energy. You're not honoring your emotions. So your emotions, when you're like biting and lashing at people and just like animalistic almost in your moods, PMS, whether it comes right before the cycle, during, or even at the later part of it, is telling you, hey, you haven't had your time to go within, to retreat, to bleed, to cleanse, to renew for your next monthly cycle. So that's just a little tidbit. But okay, so I would like to get us all dropped in. We'll start the healing and then we'll do some readings. I'm feeling like there will be one, but if there's more, I'll let you guys know. And I opened up two spots this week. It's on my, what's it called? Link in bio. So if you want your own private intuitive medium session, there's one spot on Tuesday open, one spot on Wednesday open. It'll be open for 24 hours, so you can grab that. And then, or you can come to Yalapa with us in January. But okay, that energy is going out. We're just sinking here into our root. So let's all take a deep breath in. Drop your shoulders. I have a little bit of a headache tonight, but that also can be energy coming in. Let's just all take a good long few minutes of silence together, just to let the day, the holiday, the weekend, like everything just go. So when I get prepared to do readings, it's really nice to do this like gallery style, because we're all tapping into this energy. Even if like you're driving or walking or listening to the replay, like just attuning your attention, because where attention goes, energy flows. So we're all connecting here together energetically. Okay, someone's throat is feeling really, really freaking tight. I think you might be who I'm gonna read for. But it's really cool because this is unfiltered. I don't have anyone selected, or this, you know, the skit planned of bringing someone on and you're going to tell me everything before, like literally what's coming up, I don't even know who it's for. And it's really unfiltered, really pure, really clean. This is a way to do it, in my opinion, in one-on-ones. Does everyone start to drop a little bit deeper? So just feel your body, like I can see some of you maybe like laying on a bed or a couch, like just let your arms and legs, Katie, are you laying down? like let your arms and your legs just fall. Like everyone just relax everything down. And we're all connecting in the same energy. So we'll start to receive for you. Okay. Here's the little skinny on the readings before we get started. If you want, I could see you laying down, Katie. That's why I asked. But when we get started, I'm just going to start saying things that are coming up. And so a couple of things. Notice if it relates to you, even if it's not 100%. Like if I'm like, oh, you have a brown dog with yellow spots, but you're like, I have a brown dog with pink spots. Like sometimes it's not always 100%, but be following this in ways of like, oh, that and that and that, and pay attention to your body. When your body starts to get kind of like nervous feeling, is for you. And then you can tell me, I want you to say, yes, I can take that, or yep, yes, or tell me in the comments. And then when you like, hey, I think that's me, if you are feeling brave and you want to come on live, I promise no one in this community will judge you. Or I don't know, share your news, whatever. And we'll keep it pretty private. You don't have to say everything. But I invite you, it's a lot easier for me if you can come on camera. And if not, if you're not in a situation that you can, in the comments, that'll be good. And the biggest thing on these readings, just tell me yes or no. Don't tell me. Okay, because then it's called holding the power, and you'll start to like change it. And I've done this before when I've received a reading, and you change it to kind of what you want it to talk about or hear. And I promise you, that's not as good as what will come in naturally. And Emma said, whoever wants to cry, please let it flow. Okay. Thanks, Emma. It's probably me who wants to cry. I'm kind of not really kidding. It was hard, like Thanksgiving, lots of people, and you know, just everybody needs a little time for themselves. Okay, so I'm gonna come back to this throat feeling. Your throat has felt like it's like almost like cobwebs, like it's like sandy and scratchy, and you've just been like, what is up with my throat? But you're not sick. It just feels like super dry. I'm literally seeing cobwebs, and it just, okay, I'm getting that it's also been like this for almost a month now, but it's just you've noticed it this weekend, and you thought that maybe you were having like postnasal drip or drainage. Halloween is coming up a lot. There's a lot around of this, like around Halloween. So maybe this sore throat started around Halloween. Okay, there's a black cat. I do not know. This information is coming in really fast. I don't know if you have a black cat or this is related to Halloween at this point. But there's like a dry, scratchy throat, cobwebs. And it's just feeling kind of like pausing there to let whoever this is for catch up and realize it's for them. I mean, my throat is really dry. It sounds like your mom. Yeah, I was kind of thinking that when I thought black cat, she flashed in my head. Okay, well, let me see what else comes through. Chickens. I'm seeing like lots of chickens. This one's a little bit tough because whoever I'm reading for, it's like if we're all sitting in a circle, this person's like in the second row, like they're in another layer of this energy. The color yellow is coming through. Maybe like this person wears like a yellow piece of clothing, like a yellow shirt. I'm seeing like white pieces on this yellow shirt. Katie, I am seeing your mom right now too. And so this can be for her. This can be for multiple people. I'm going to keep going. Okay, black and white cat. There's like lots of cats, chickens, the color yellow. The throat is super dry and scratchy. And there's an elderly man, like a grandpa or a father figure, coming in on like my left side. And I want to say that he had glasses. And like fine white hair that kind of does like this little flip of the white hair, almost like a squarish kind of jaw. So he's on left side. A lot of times that means maternal, but it doesn't have to always. Emma's picking up a scarf. So there's this connection with this older man who's just kind of like calling, welcoming forward, like he's in like inviting her to something. She also has a white cat. Okay, Katie, I'm just gonna keep going with this and just let me know yes or no, and she can catch this replay if it ends up being for her. Now I'm seeing the candles. Okay, that I do know about your mom now. So as she's like making candles, doing things with candles, there's like a lot of cats around her. You might ask her if she's had yellow on in the last couple days. And I feel like she feels this spirit, this energy around her. Like she's like doing her thing with her crafts. And this guy is like kind of spooking her, like maybe knocking things over or just like impressioning on her heart. Like maybe she's felt emotional and she might blame it on hormones. Like she has just felt something going on and she's not really sure how to explain it. And my throat's getting better as I'm talking about this. So she's like in her workspace. Does she have a dedicated place for her like candle making? Like I'm seeing a white table and maybe almost like it's in the basement maybe. And it's like its own space. Like what they're showing me is I had a friend in elementary school whose mom made quilts and she had like this whole basement space set up for her quilt making. Like it was like amazing. It was like kind of, okay, basement. Yes. Okay. So I think this is your mom. I just feel like she needs to loosen up her body a little bit. Like her body needs like movement, like spinal movement, like even like cat cows on the floor. Like she has a lot of energy stuck. Like she's really, this is really positive, Katie, for your mom. Like she's really ascending and she's going through some like physical, they're like showing me, they're like, you hate this. I do hate this a little bit because I think a lot of people's chronic illness gets chalked up as ascension symptoms. When it's not, but this is literally ascension symptoms. This is like she's transforming and shifting. And like the key for her is for her to, she has some symptoms that are chronic that have not relented, but she has some of these new things that are coming in that are like really random. I'm seeing bubblegum. I don't know. That'll make sense to her, but almost like bubblegum pops, or she knows what the bubblegum means. But like they're coming in and they're not making sense and they're like they're there and then they're gone and then she cannot get over. She is feeling this I'm wondering, I think it's her grandpa, but it could be your grandpa. Left side, like who, she's feeling this energy. When she's in the basement working on it, like it makes me want to cry. She's feeling this and she's denying it. Or she's feeling it and she doesn't have the awareness, the tools, and the vocabulary. No one's taught her how to feel energies and spirits. So, and it's even, you know, in our society, it's like, it's weird. Like, weird spirits, people that are dead. Oh, it's weird. Like, all right, come on, girl. Like, it's the thing. But the chickens, man. Did this person have chickens? Yeah, I just explained to her what ascension symptoms are a few weeks ago. Well, does she have chickens or did this gentleman? I also just did energy healing her on Friday and she also has a lot of blockages, including her throat. It's like her whole spinal column all the way up. Not sure who the man is or who the chickens are. Does she, it's getting stronger. Glasses, like a whiff. He kind of looks like the guy on Up. Like the balloon, that's just what I'm seeing. Like the balloon, the Pixar balloon movie. It's been many, many years since I've seen it. Maybe she's watched that movie. Grandpa possibly, he may have grown up on a farm. But there's chickens, this guy from the Up. I think that's, is that the movie? Someone let me know about that. I'm not seeing that he was super heavy. But just like the squarish face, the glasses, the hair that kind of like whips over, like good front hair. Like he wasn't really bald. And that movie, you know, that movie is sad, I think. I don't really remember what it's about. I just remember feeling really sad the whole time I watched it. And that is what's coming up. Like there's sadness from him to her. And I don't know. Thanks, guys, on the movie confirmation. My head's hurting really bad, so it is this energy. Let me see if he can. It's like he wants to give her something. I'm excited for every single person to attune to their spiritual gifts that is listening to this because it is literally like Pictionary and charades with the spirit world. Because you can't hear them. Are, but it's like he wants to like give her something. He's like, I don't know what he's doing with his hands. Okay, I'm seeing some black, like maybe he wore a lot of black or like a tuxedo or suit, some sort of. This will make sense to her. It will, when she'll know exactly what I'm talking about. So don't put pressure on yourself, Katie, if you don't know. So it's like he always wore like a black suit jacket, white shirt, or had been seen in that. I want to say this is around her wedding, that there was something, there's a lot of sadness maybe around her wedding and this person. Did he not go? Has she ever told you that story? Like if he didn't go or if he, yeah. So when she's in the basement and she's making her candles, does she do quilts too, or is that just what I'm seeing? But when she's in the basement working, she's feeling this energy. She's feeling this, it's a loving presence. It's either a father or a grandfather that loves her very much and like wants to give her something. And he's giving all these clues and the throat's tightening. Like I think when she's listening to this, she's gonna get really sad. Like her throat's gonna tighten up. They eloped, they had a reception. I'm not sure if he was at her wedding. No quilts. Okay, thank you for the clarification. Like in a big deep relief, like it's going to be okay. Like if all the things, this is for your mom, if all of the things that you're going through that doesn't feel like you can make it through, or doesn't, you feel like your prayers aren't being heard, you feel like these things are piling up, but there's this gentleman who's like, I mean, he's coming through for you. He's coming through to give you something, to give you a message. You don't need my help with this message. Like this is plenty. Like she will know. And when she listens to this, she's like, I don't know. And I'm confused now more than ever. I hear her saying that, Like, no, what? Like, trust yourself. Get out a piece of paper right now as you're listening to this, and everyone can do this, but write three true things. Three true things that you know to be true. And there's your message. Okay. Katie, let me know if you have any questions. I'm going to leave it there, and then we can do one more reading, and then we'll call it a night. So if you, I know there's a lot of people that have been coming on these lives, like, and they feel, they're like, I'm on here. I know there's an energy or like an angel or somebody who wants to talk with me. I feel a message. I just feel like I need help receiving it. One, you might not need help. You might just get out a pen and paper after being in this energy and jot it down. Or two, I have two spots open this week, 30-minute slots, one on Tuesday, one on Wednesday. The link is in my bio for intuitive medium reading if you feel like you need support and if you feel called. So you're welcome, girl. All right, let's do one more. And I'm getting this as kind of a collective group feeling, but if it becomes individual, I'll let you know. Hold on, I gotta grab something. Okay, I'm back. They were just over there. I'm gonna grab my affirmation cards. I feel like this is gonna be really helpful. Okay. I'll just settle in, tune in. There's a black lab coming through right away. Hello, dog. Big, happy, just like this black lab is just so smiley. And I'm hearing like maybe it wasn't a full lab. So don't, if you had an all black dog with a black face that was very happy and just looked up at you, this is for you. Please let me know if this is for you. So there's this black lab-like dog, big happy face still looking up. And if I've read for you before or even recently, this could still be you. Don't feel like you're stealing the show. Big happy dog just looking up. Such a sweet puppy. So animals, they don't necessarily have to be crossed over to come through to us because their energies and their souls are so pure. Emma's this your dog? Is it Carter? I don't know who Carter is, but let me know if this is your dog. That'd be helpful. Just like the happiest, sweetest dog. Okay, baseballs are coming up, or like balls. Like it likes to like fetch or play. Okay, yes. Likes to fetch or play with balls. It likes to just like that tail wag is intense. Like just the tail shakes the whole back end. Yeah. Okay. So this is your dog. Aw, your dogs always come through. I love it. Okay. So I'm going to pull a card for you here in a second. There's a message. But the dog's still alive? Or no? Yeah, she always shows balls. What a good girl. She is so happy. That's just like, she's just like, the trending sound on reels. It's like, because I'm happy, happy, happy. That's just like what she's singing. She's like, happy. Okay, gone in 2019. Happy, happy girl. And she would like put her paws like maybe on your belly. So was she with you when you were pregnant with Parker? I'm curious. Yeah, answer that for me, because I think that's where she's leading us. Were you pregnant with Parker when you had her? Or was Parker? Yeah, because she got in 2019. What year is it even? I don't even know anymore. So yeah, Parker's probably right around that time. Kind of, she was my dog at my mom's house, teen 20s. What's up with Worlds of Fun? Did something happen there that was unsettling for you around this time? Was she anything? Okay, was she a stray? Did somebody like find her and pick her up? Because now I'm seeing like a dog at Worlds of Fun, and my dog was found at Worlds of Fun, so that can always be what she's showing. But this is definitely for you and your dog. And I'm seeing like a white dog house that she would go into. It's choking you up a little bit, like your throat. She's definitely Dylan's parking lot. They were giving puppies away in the cold. Okay.
That makes sense.
Okay. So, like, those who are tuning into your own energies and souls that come through for you, sometimes you're shown something that will make sense to you that's not the other person. So, like, I've seen my dog, Maya, at Worlds of Fun, but she was a stray and she was picked up, and so this makes sense. Okay. Glow sticks. Emma, what is up with purple glow sticks? Purple glow sticks, we've figured out the World's a Fun thing. Did she chew on a glow stick? How did she pass away? It's like something, maybe like a chemical. Did she get into something? How did she go? Let me know. But I think I'm... She's just like, her paw is towards the cards. So I'm going to pull you a message actually right here. And I'm just going to read it from her to you. But whatever, she wants to show me how she passed away. Don't tell me, but just let me know if you can confirm if it's has to do with chemicals or she got into. Oh my gosh, she chewed on everything. She went in old age. Maya lifted her head and looked at me when you said that. Yeah, her, she was born in Worlds of Fun. Or not born in Worlds of Fun, found at Worlds of Fun. Okay. Emma, do you have a question for her? What is her name? Does it start with an S? Did her hearing get really bad as she got older? That's just what she's... I had a cat that died by antifreeze. Okay. It's not... I mean, yes, but that's not really what she wants to show me. Just like that she chew... I'm just saying she was chewing on purple glow sticks. What is your question for her? There's the Dylans. I think you said was it at Dylans they were given? Yeah, Dylans they were given away puppies in the cold. She's just such a lovely, like, spirit. I know she has guidance. Maybe what is it? I'm just going to read you this card that I pulled. Okay. Balance. It's an affirmations deck. It's lovely. Heart or mind, body or soul, creative or calculated, masculine or feminine, soft or strong, spirit or science, momentum or rest, sun or moon, summer or winter. What is life but a beautiful, delicious mixture of both? Perhaps it doesn't have to be one or the other. Perhaps we were made to be some things, but then also everything all in one. After all, the sun and the moon exist together in the sky. It is simply our perspective that keeps us from seeing both at the same time. Cool. It was November. She was my queen. Oh, she's just coming to say hi and finding your balance. I think she's going to stay around, so I'll let you know. I'll send you a message if she comes in with anything else. I'm actually kind of losing my oomph tonight. I can feel the blood, like, draining from my face. So I'm going to close this here. If you feel like you need private support, a reading, what's really cool, and I always say, never say never, but this has never happened. I'm always like, am I going to have the reading where, like, nothing comes through and I'm just going to, like, refund the person? That's never happened yet. So the private readings, they're pretty powerful because it's one-on-one for the whole time. And it's just like all things, like all the messages, like if you haven't checked the mail in 6 months, it's like all that trying to come through at once. And so it's bam, 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 bam. And we record it, but I'm going to close this here. Emma, I will stay open. What is her name? It sounds like a Sadie to me, but I can't make it out. And I had a dog named Sadie, so you have to let me know. But thank you guys for coming. I'm going to send out an email about where I'll be now for work and a little bit of everything that transpired tomorrow. So if you're not on my email list, head over into inspirehealthbyjen.com, subscribe, sign up for whatever free thing we're offering. It will put you on there and you'll get the emails. I will not spam you. You can unsubscribe at any time. And we will keep this party going. So we will go the next couple weeks and then we're going to break for a while around Christmas. I think we'll meet on New Year's Day and then we'll be off for a while in January. I'll be traveling. So come get the readings while you can. Come join this community while we're here. And I'll see everyone next week.